Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of turbocharger failure. Turbochargers used to be relatively uncommon technology in the gasoline automotive world. Looking back to the year 2000, only about 1% of all gasoline cars produced featured a turbocharger, and that is compared to in 2019, about 35% of all gasoline passenger vehicles included a turbocharger. And looking at the modern day, 2024 moving into 2025 model years, that number is likely a lot closer to 50%, if not maybe even a little bit higher. But ultimately, even over those last 5 years, a lot has changed in terms of more and more manufacturers and engines moving to a turbocharged design. Now, part of that is to create smaller, more efficient engines with the use of turbochargers while still being able to create a significant amount of power from these small displacement engines. So it's no wonder the technology has become so much more popular. But another thing is turbochargers are also a lot more popular nowadays because their design really is a lot more robust and a lot more reliable than what it was looking back to the 70s, 80s, and 90s. So that's certainly another factor that has contributed to more and more manufacturers moving to turbocharged engines. With that being said, these modern turbos often can last pretty close to the lifetime of the engine and often 150,000 plus miles before turbochargers start running into failure just due to natural wear and tear and abuse. Turbochargers can and still do fail before that type of mileage, whether that be defects in the turbos or modding and tuning vehicles. That certainly puts more stress on turbochargers and can reduce their effective lifespan and longevity. The main point is turbochargers are something that take a lot of abuse and a lot of wear and tear over their lives. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump into a few of the most common signs and symptoms of a failing turbocharger. Symptom number one on the list, we have burning oil and smoke from the exhaust. This is something that, depending on the turbo failure, can be very excessive if you experience a very sudden turbocharger failure. But ultimately, in most cases, when a turbo starts failing, it'll start failing over the course of thousands or even tens of thousands of miles. And so this burning oil and smoke from the exhaust can start off a little bit slower. And as turbo failure progresses, then those symptoms will also continue getting worse and worse. So something to keep in mind there. Circling back to the point about a drastic or sudden severe turbocharger failure, this can be one of the most obvious signs, and it really can be incredible how much smoke and how much oil the engine and turbocharger can burn very rapidly if you run into a severe failure. I know I ran into this personally on a BMW that I had modified. When I did run into that turbocharger failure, I was able to pull over safely and shut the engine down within a matter of about 30 or 45 seconds of the failure. By that point, the turbocharger and engine had already dumped about 6 out of the 7 liters of oil in the engine into the exhaust. And when the turbo blew, I could barely see out the rear view mirror because the smoke was just so thick and dense. So again, just wanted to point that out in the sense that if you do run into a sudden drastic turbo failure, often this can be very serious and you want to make sure you get to somewhere that you can pull off safely. If you continue driving for too long like that, you very well may run the engine too low on oil and ultimately causing severe engine failure and damage. Moving on to symptom number two, I have a couple things kind of lumped together here, and that is power loss, poor performance, and a laggy feel. So all turbochargers have some degree of turbo lag, and as turbos begin failing, they'll often start spinning and building boost slower and slower, and might even not be able to spin to the point that they can create max boost or the target boost that the car's computer is asking for. And so when this happens, this will often cause these feelings of poor performance, again, a very laggy, slow acceleration feel. Now, as is the case again with the burning oil and smoke from the exhaust, this is another one of those symptoms that tends to start off gradually. You might not even notice it at first, but as the turbocharger failure progresses, it will become worse and worse, and these symptoms will become more and more noticeable. For symptom number three, we have whining noises. So as turbos begin failing, they will often create a very high-pitched whining sound. It can often sound a little bit like a whistle or a high-pitched siren. So if you're hearing that whining sound, especially with a couple of these other symptoms, then that can be a dead giveaway that you do have a turbo failure at hand and that your turbo is slowly wearing down and giving out. And as with the other symptoms, this is something as turbo failure gradually becomes worse and worse. Oftentimes that whining or siren-like sound will become louder and more noticeable as that turbocharger failure continues progressing. Last but not least, symptom number four of turbocharger problems, we have the check engine light. So this is a very straightforward problem. Modern engines have very capable ECUs that can quickly and efficiently pick up on a lot of different problems with a vehicle. So in the case of a turbocharger failure, again, with the check engine light, this often ties back into what I talked about with the poor performance, laggy feel, and the turbocharger ultimately not being able to reach its intended boost pressure or taking excessively long to get to that target boost pressure. So when the ECU is calling for X amount of boost, depending on the conditions, let's say it's maybe 10 pounds of boost, and you're only getting to 7 pounds of boost or 8 pounds of boost, then a lot of the times the computer will pick up on that and trigger a boost under target code, or similarly associated codes with the boost taking excessively long to get there, or just not reaching that target in general. So if you're getting a check engine light with those fault codes, that can be further confirmation that you are indeed having issues with your turbocharger or turbochargers. Ultimately, that wraps up the most common signs and symptoms of turbocharger failure. One thing to mention in general, especially if you experience early turbo failure, are a couple of the common causes, since there are causes of turbo failure that if they are not addressed, you could continue running into similar issues and premature wear and tear and failure of the turbo. So with that said, let's go ahead and discuss a couple of the most common causes of turbo failure and things to look out for before you actually go ahead and opt to get the turbochargers replaced. Common cause number one is poor lubrication or dirty oil. Just like the engine, turbochargers are very reliant on having a fresh, quality flow of oil running through them. And so if you do have any sort of oiling or lubrication issues, whether that be things like low oil pressure, old dirty oil, or improper oil for your vehicle, engine, or modifications, so that's an important thing to consider if you ran into that issue. Check the oil, make sure everything is correct, maybe even send the oil in for analysis to a company like Blackstone Laboratories and get some information on the oil to see if anything's happening, like fuel dilution or other things that could be leading to premature wear and tear of the turbocharger. Another common cause of turbo failure is overspinning or overboosting, as well as boost leaks. Ultimately, boost leaks are something that can lead to both overspinning and overboosting the turbocharger. And so ultimately, there are a couple different things here. Usually this happens when, number one, you are tuning and modifying the engine and simply running more boost than the turbocharger was designed to handle. Or in another case, if you have a boost leak, that is something that the ECU is targeting X amount of boost pressure. Let's say it's 10 PSI. If it is struggling to reach that amount of PSI because you have a boost leak and some of that pressurized air is actually escaping, the ECU is going to continue trying to spool the turbo more aggressively to reach that intended boost output. And again, if you have a boost leak, it's gonna be a lot harder to reach that. And that's ultimately something that can lead to essentially overboosting or overspinning the turbocharger. So a couple things to be on the lookout for there if you do run into failure, potentially due to overboosting or overspinning it. Last but not least, another common cause of turbocharger failure is simply natural wear and tear or turbo seal failure. Now, in the case of the turbo seals, that is something that can also happen because of overboosting or overspinning the turbocharger. Those additional pressures can wear down the seals on the turbo, but otherwise those seals, as well as other parts, can just take natural wear and tear over time. So ultimately, if you end up running into turbocharger failure at 150,000 plus miles or somewhere in that ballpark, in all likelihood, that failure was likely just caused by natural wear and tear and the turbo reaching the end of its useful lifespan. Now, turbo failure and replacing the turbo is a very expensive job depending on the vehicle. A single turbo can often run in the ballpark of roughly $500 up to $1,500 or more. Again, greatly depends on the vehicle and engine in question and specifically what kind of turbo or turbos are being used. If this happens later on in the lifetime of the vehicle, replacing it and spending a lot on an older vehicle can be a daunting task and something that you may feel like isn't worthwhile just on an older, less valuable vehicle. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description for more. Thanks, everyone.